say, oh, I'm about to tell you to run.
Oh boy, oh boy.
The moment I say, the moment I am. Well, pick me up with golden hand. Oh, I'm about to say, oh, I'm about to tell you to run.
Oh boy, oh boy.
The moment I say, the moment I am. Well, I would like to hold my little hand. I will bell run with, I will bell cry with. I would like to hold my little hand. I will bell run with, I will bell cry.
I got a rice cooking in the microwave. Got a 3-day beard I don't plan to shave. And it's a goofy thing, but I just gotta say, hey, I'm a doing alright. Yeah, I think I'll make me some homemade soup. I'm feeling pretty good, and that's the truth. It's neither drink nor drug induced, no, I'm just doing alright. And it's a great day to be alive. I know the sun's still shining when I close my eyes. There's some hard times in the neighborhood, but why can't every day be just this good? Since I left home, said good luck to every seed I'd sown. Give it my best and then I left it alone. I hope they're doing all right. Now I look in the mirror and what do I see? A long wolf there staring back at me. Long in the tooth but harmless as can be. Lord, I guess he's doing all right. And it's a great day to be alive. I know the sun's still shining when I close my eyes. There's some hard times in the neighborhood, but why? Sometimes it's lonely, sometimes it's only me and the shadows that fill this room. Sometimes I'm falling, desperately calling, howling out. My old Harley for a 3-day cruise. Might even grow me a Fu Manchu. And it's a great day to be alive. I know the sun's still shining when I close my eyes. There's some hard times in the neighborhood, but why can't every day be just this good? It's a great day to be alive. I know the sun's still shining. Hard times in the neighborhood, but why can't every day be just this good?
All right, here we are, day two. Glacier Park. Joey's leading the way for Drew and me. Yesterday we left Pegan's Pass.
Carrying everything for him.
Carrying everything for us. Yesterday we left Pegan's Pass and stayed the night at Mini Glacier. And today we're headed to Ptarmigan. So yesterday was a 13.2 mile day, about the same today. And if we don't die, we'll see you towards the end. Phone doesn't do justice. All right, we're at the bottom of Dawn Mist Falls. Even from this distance, I'm getting pretty wet. Got about 3 more miles so we make it to camp. Second footbridge today. This one's a little bit longer, which makes it a lot more wobbly. Comes out of a beautiful creek. Turn this off so I can hold on.
Monsooning outside. We got in last night at a good time, set up camp, and just as we went to bed it started sprinkling, and now we might need an arc to get to our next spot. But we're gonna head out anyway. Farewell.
Someone told me long ago there's a calm before. Down!
The sun is finally starting to come out. Look over here, you can see a break in the clouds, got some blue skies. Just to show you, there's where we slept. Walk about 20 feet and you got this beautiful lake with waterfalls coming down. Waterfalls all through the mountains here. They're small. About 20 of them. I would try fishing this lake, but most of the year it's frozen over, so probably just recently thawed out. Not gonna be much life in it. I'm gonna pack up camp and head out in the next 30 minutes or so. Just so everyone knows, this is what the majority of the last 2 days have consisted of. Yesterday being worse because it was raining all day. The ground below was muddy. We were soaked. But as far as you can see, it's nothing but woods. Uphill, downhill. Joey's about to teach us bear spray techniques.
But you just want to shoot it so that it's going to be inhaled by the bear. That's what you want. You want its face to engulf in that. That picture is like, that is the fire. You have a fire extinguisher and you're trying to get the fire extinguisher out. You want to like get it right on the money. You want it to be where she's coming right into. If it's a strong wind, it's just going to blow back in your face. You know, don't spray it. A lot of people spray it when people are like, when the bear's way off, right? I tell them, don't do that. This is your last resort right here. So we're doing it this way, but I mean, basically, it's gonna be like that. That's it.
You're gonna blow this way?
What?
You're gonna blow this way?
You'll know. Pretty sure that's downwind.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue.
All right, so we just spent the last three or four hours down there, all the way back around this mountain. Just got to the top where we can finally see over the tree line. We gotta go up some more before we hit our descent.
Isn't that amazing? The clouds just like completely dissipate.
Yeah.
I told you I didn't 3 minutes specifically.
About 30 minutes ago, not even that, we put our coats on because we thought it was gonna rain, but then just like that, it cleared up. So hopefully in the next hour and a half, we'll be at camp.
The bright, blessed day, the dark, sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by.
All right, so this is 50 Mountain. Looking at the view. beautiful. Joey says grizzlies frequent this area, so if we're lucky, we'll see one from a distance. If we're unlucky, we'll see one closer. All right, so we're doing our descent now. And just to give you an idea, that's how the path works. You can just see it up ahead. Not really on this camera, but it just cuts a windy path through the wildflowers and the mountains. Some small lakes, ponds, streams running through the hills. We should be at camp in about 20 minutes, so this will conclude day 4. And then tomorrow we're either gonna hike out 11 miles to the road or 11 miles to the next campsite and then finish the following day. So it's gonna depend on how our bodies feel in the morning. It's starting to get cold now, so I'm gonna pack up, get the jacket on, and that'll be it.
I watch them grow. They learn much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
All right, we're here on day 5. Just left camp. About 12:35, and I think Joey's gonna show us the way out. So tonight we're gonna be back at the van. I don't know about them, but my body's shutting down. So this is a lot of our view today. Some burn. Yesterday had
the exit button.
Yeah, we're pressing the exit button, but yesterday's elevation was the highest, and our good friend Joey here didn't fill us in on all the details, so elevation went higher and higher every day. Today we're gonna barely break 1,000 total, and it's gonna be split, so compared to yesterday's almost 3,000, it'll be a much more enjoyable trip. So hopefully the battery lasts on this camera and we can get some pictures on the way out. Might even see a bear, who knows.
Staring at a maple leaf, leaning on the mother tree. I said to myself, we all lost touch. Your favorite fruit is chocolate-covered cherries and seedless watermelon. No, nothing from the ground is good enough. Body ride.
Mountains.
Look what's over me, oh chariot, your golden waves are walking down.
My first time experiencing a hitchhike, probably true too. you.